Hi, everybody. This is Lisa.
And this is Joe.
And welcome to your Cheap Date Show for February 16th, 2008. On this week's show,
Carefrees, $5 a piece. Nice. That doesn't even make sense.
No, we're making fun of someone.
We are.
He knows who he is.
We'll get to that in a second. Welcome to the Cheap Date Show, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry, I didn't mean to shout in your ear. Welcome to the Cheap Date Show, and we hope you enjoy your stay for the next 30 minutes or so. Or so.
Or you can fast forward, too, if you want.
That's true. You know what? There's something really cool that happens at 17 minutes and 37 seconds. So go ahead and fast forward. We'll wait. I have no idea what's going to happen at that point, but
yeah, I don't know how you're planning to make that happen.
I'll just keep an eye on the clock and go, oh man, we better do something interesting.
Okay.
Okay. So anyway,
let's do something interesting now.
Okay. Let's. Okay. Anyway, let's talk about why Carefrees are $5.
First of all, why don't you tell us, Joseph, what a Carefree is?
Well, we had a lovely little Chicago area podcaster meetup, a mini one, with the folks with Jen and Alan from the Dinkycast and the famous Barely of Barely Podcasting.
The famous
Barely of Barely Podcasting. And we met at the Lamplighter Inn in Palatine, which oddly enough is right across the street from the place we reviewed on the last show. So we didn't have to travel too far.
Oh, I get it. They have carafe.
Yes. Specials. They have carafes.
Carafes.
So we're teasing Barely because he referred to them. He when we got the bill, he looked at it, he said, why are they charging us Carefrees? And actually it was, because it kind of looked like Carefree on the abbreviation.
Yeah, after drinking a carafe, I'm sure it did.
What were the carafes? Tell us about the carafes.
Leinenkugels.
Served in a carafe like you get wine served in.
Yeah, well, I mean, it was like a slightly classier version of a beer pitcher.
Mm-hmm.
And I think, like, maybe smaller than a beer pitcher. Appropriately definitely priced, but it was, like, if a beer pitcher is 3 pints or 4 pints, this was more like 3 pints.
It was a 32-ounce carafe.
Oh, what it was. Well, so, you know more, so it's 2 pints. You know more about it than I do.
Well, you know the math, so 32 ounces would be,
yes, I can
pints.
Divide.
16 plus 16, okay, very good. And we had, yeah, so it was Leinenkugels. It was,
I'm brilliant.
It was $3.75, right, for each of these carafes.
Mm-hmm.
We had actually got, all five of us were sitting at the table and we were talking about what we were going to have. It's like, oh, Leinenkugels, all the way around. And then our server said, well, you know what, you can just, we have the carafe special and you can save some money that way. Want me to bring you 3 or 4 of those? Oh, sure, just bring them on over.
3 or 4. Yeah, that was a little more than we needed, but.
So we had a lovely visit with Jen and Alan and with Barely. We were sitting at the Lamplighter. The Lamplighter is split into separate areas. There, when we first got there, there's a bar area, which is a classic.
Yeah.
We were sitting there playing the trivia machine, playing the game there while we were waiting for the guys to show up. And then there's a separate room, which is a dining room, which is sort of, it's an older building that we should mention. The building was put up in the late 1850s. And it's been a meeting hall. It's been a whole bunch of different places. And it's been a bar and a restaurant for many, many years. And in its most recent incarnation, it's been the Lamplighter since for about the past 30 years or so. And it's been
very good.
But anyway, the area we were sitting in was almost like being in the front room of an old house, basically.
Yeah, kind of. The bar got pretty busy though.
Yes, the bar was rocking. Plus, there's a private party upstairs.
Mm-hmm.
They have, as I said, they have a bar area. They have the area we were sitting in, which is the dining area, which would seat probably, would you say,
30, 40
people
30.
Probably. And then upstairs, they have a party room, but then they also have a patio outside as well. So on the weekend evenings, actually during the week too, they have specials going on all the time. They have various, they have karaoke, they have bands playing there. And
that stuff's all upstairs, right?
Mm-hmm. And the place gets pretty hopping during sometimes. But anyway, we were there not only to have the Leinenkugels, but we were there to have the food. And we were all over the map on the menu, weren't we?
Yeah. Our food choices were as diverse as our drink choices.
We should say our food selections, because the choices were pretty expansive. Our selections wound up being rather narrow.
Go semantics. Yes. We all picked the Build-A-Burger.
What did you have on yours?
With minor variations. Well, I had a veggie burger.
Oh.
Mine was furthest off.
The vegetarian thing rears its little head again, doesn't it?
You know what? I had had a hot dog and, like, biscuits and gravy, and, oh, I've eaten so much meat this weekend. The veggie burger was very good. Nothing really to report about it. Little shoestring fries hit the spot.
Right. Everyone else pretty much had a Build-A-Burger. I had the, and what is it? It's a quarter? Is it a quarter pound?
Oh, Angus I couldn't patty? Even tell you.
You have a lot of choices on this. I decided to go for an Angus or the Build-A-Burger with cheddar, and it comes with the standard burger stuff. It comes with lettuce and onion and tomato on the side. You put that on or off or whatever. You get your choice of American cheddar, mozzarella, provolone, Swiss cheeses, bacon, mushroom, grilled onions, and guacamole. And you get blue cheese for another buck.
Guacamole.
Mm-hmm. That is. It's really good stuff. The bun was fresh. Oh, and I got waffle fries, which were great. I'm always up about the fresh buns. Yeah, it was the bread was fresh, and I had waffle fries, which were really good.
Mm-hmm.
They were well done. I always love my fries well done, so that was great. Barely had. What did he have on his burger?
Bacon, cheese, cheddar, maybe bacon, yeah. Cheddar, and mushroom. And he had his burger cooked rare. I've never heard anybody do that. Well, I admire a man who's not afraid of rare meat.
And that's barely. He's not afraid. So he had that. And then I don't recall exactly what Jen and Alan had.
I don't either. I only and I don't even remember what you had. I only remembered Barely's because it was the most manly burger I had ever heard of.
Now, also, we had the soup. They had a soup there, which was really, really good. Which is something I normally would not have ordered, but it was really good.
But you were feeling nuts.
Stuffed green pepper soup.
Yeah, that is interesting, isn't it? And it tasted just like a stuffed green pepper.
Mm-hmm. It was green, very green peppery. It had some ground beef in it, and it had rice.
Like your standard green pepper stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was delicious. It was just like...
Only soupy.
Yeah, exactly. It was delicious.
Actually, it was. It was like they chopped up stuffed green peppers and... added some broth.
Lisa also learned the fine points of how you don't pour yourself your own drink, especially if you're in Japan. So we had adopted
yes,
that.
Yes, we followed the Japanese custom.
We followed that very early on. Right. We started pouring beer for each other. So your glass was never empty. It's a great place, a casual place.
Eh?
The most expensive thing on the menu is, I think, the lasagna. But most of the entrees, the sandwiches, the burgers, the sandwiches, the BLTs are all in the like $5.50 range. Oh, lasagna is $8.99, a large slice of baked lasagna. But everything else on the menu is between $5.50 and $7.
Mm-hmm. And all just good solid pub food.
Mm-hmm. It is. And especially with the beer specials, you can't beat it. And mm-hmm. then they have a kids menu. Hot dog and fries, $3.69. Pizza, bread and fries, $3.69. When my kids were little, I wish I would have known about this place because this would have been perfect for them. Chicken fingers and fries, $4.99. So you know, it's a great, it's reasonable. The service was very good. Our server was very attentive.
Yeah, we had a great time.
So that is the Lamplighter Inn Tavern and Grill. It's located at 60 North Bothwell Street in Palatine, Illinois. And you can also visit their website at lamplighters.com. Now. Before we jump into our next thing, well, we should jump into our next thing, which was one of the purposes of this evening was that we were going to go out and have a good time, and there was a band that we wanted to see right up the street at Durty Nellie's Pub. Durty Nellie's, for those of you who aren't in the Chicago area, it's been a neighborhood fixture since the early 70s. This is where a lot of bands played. Ted Nugent's mom, Ma Nugent. She was a huge supporter of the local music scene here.
So I've heard.
In fact, she used to have a column in the Illinois Entertainer, which is one of the free papers around here, where people would write in and ask for advice. She had an advice column in there, so you could write to her and say, you know, my boyfriend was
Ma Nugent's advice column.
Exactly, it was very cool. And in fact, last August they dedicated a memorial to Ma Nugent right in front of Durty Nellie's.
So there's
We didn't see it because it was dark and it was very
like
snowy
degrees.
And it was really cold. So we just kind of whisked our way in. So
we did.
The band we wanted to see, we wound up not seeing the band we went there to see.
Well, yeah, we're kind of lightweight and really expected the main event to start more like 10 o'clock and it started a little bit at midnight. So
right.
We'd already been there for a couple hours, so.
So the band we did see, we should give them a thumbs up because they were pretty good.
I thought they were great.
Yeah. What was the name of the band?
Given to Fly?
Given to Fly. Two with a number two.
You can check them out at pearljamband.com. Right.
They're a Pearl yeah. Jam.
Tribute band, I think.
Yes.
I don't think anybody wants to be a cover band
anymore. Oh, that's
anymore.
True. Yeah, tribute band.
But yeah, they played all Pearl Jam. They did not play Even Flow, which is funny because they played for like 2 hours. You would think they could pretty
exactly.
much.
And considering that's in Guitar Hero 3 and everybody in the world now plays that song in Guitar Hero 3.
But yeah, they were good. They were a lot of fun.
And this was
apparently this was their second gig together, but they were very, very good. That surprised me a lot.
They were all very good. The you identified the before they even sang note number one, you could tell by the lead singer's posture at the microphone that mm-hmm. oh geez.
Wasn't that funny? We didn't even know who they were. And Joe made some comment about the lead singer and I said, looks like Eddie Vedder. And
sure enough.
He opened his mouth and it was Eddie Vedder.
So we're gonna go back to Durty Nellie's and we're gonna do a proper review of the place. Because it's been around for years. They actually completely rebuilt it down the street a little bit from where it stood originally. It's been in this location since 2003. There's on the second level, there's an Irish restaurant up there. Imagine.
That's the place to be. Sit up there and watch the band.
When we went into the room, we went to one entrance that took us right into the club. They gave us a little hand stamp, and it was...
I think it was Ted.
I'm pretty sure it was Ted Nugent. And then there's a huge, just a massive bar there. And did you take a look at this this beer list?
I did not, but I'm impressed.
Huge bar, and then a nice sizable room. It's standing room only, and then the band. The stage is a pretty good size. It was good. It was a good time. And then if you're in the restaurant area, the restaurant is actually on the second level, and there were people overlooking the main floor,
mm-hmm.
so they could see what was going on.
That was the place to be. I mean, honestly, I was not wearing the appropriate shoes to be standing on concrete for 2 hours. Which sounds really wimpy, but actually it's hard standing on concrete for 2 hours.
I had, what was it called?
It was a Red Hook Copper Hook, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm looking for it on here.
Under American
Pale. Oh, American Pale Ale, yeah.
And it was good. It was, I am not a big fan of the pale ales, but this was not as hoppy as some of the IPAs I've had in the past. And it was good. I enjoyed it. In fact, I think everybody, you had a vodka tonic.
Yeah, it was off
around
a little
bit. I don't know if Jen had anything.
Yeah, and I think all you guys had the Copper Hook, right? Yeah. They do have a nice beer list here. But I don't know how you would... I guess you could see the taps on some of it. It's kind of a lot of options to be confronted with in a dark, loud room. So it's easy to just go for the special. I don't blame you for doing that.
They had Shinerbach on tap. They had several things on tap that you don't normally see.
They have Founder's Blushing Monk, extremely rare and limited. They have a raspberry beer and a cherry beer. They have, this is really impressive, actually.
We'll have to go back for the beer.
Yeah, so we will.
We're going to go back and we'll do a proper review of Durty Nellie's, but we wanted to mention it because it is right up the street from the Lamplighter. In fact, when we were waiting in the bar, we overheard some people saying, well, you start here and we'll head up to Nellie's and we'll go from there.
Ooh, Palatine gets crazy.
I'm telling you.
I've heard about Palatine, but that was the first time we'd been there for a night out. And
almost as nuts as Wakanda?
It's a little bit more hardcore than Arlington Heights, I can tell
That's
you
true.
That.
Do we need to talk about our night in Wakanda? Or do we need to go?
No.
Story for another time.
Story for the Joe Ratting Out Lisa podcast.
Oh, no. I'd never rat you out to our listeners. They love you. Do you have I'll do nothing to damage your reputation with them.
You need to get me a few vodka tonics before the show starts sometime, and then I'll rat myself out. Oh, yes, so this is one time we were in Wakanda, and...
So this dude comes up. He's got a boat.
And there was a dude with a boat and some weed.
A boat and some weed and some really big ideas.
Okay.
Which we'll share at a future date.
Moving on.
We're going to go ahead and do a proper Durty Nellie's review at some point in the future. In the meantime, they're at 180 North Smith Street, and a link will be on our show notes. And if you're looking for a place to see music, this would be a really cool place to go because some of the bigger name bands that play around the Chicago suburbs, so keep it in perspective, but the more popular bands do play there. So,
And really reasonable with a $6 cover.
Thank you. Okay, so we have a little bit of business to catch up from last time. We promised that we would talk about listener Chris's review of Cafe Matou.
Oh, yeah.
He went to a beer dinner a couple weeks ago at Cafe Matou, which is a French restaurant that has primarily a large wine selection.
Mm-hmm.
But at some point, they're going to start carrying a rotating selection of good Belgian beers. The Cafe Matou is located at Milwaukee Avenue between North and Armitage. They had a five-course dinner. The appetizer was cured salmon and marinated herring. Their soup was a celery bisque with ham. The salad was endive and cheese salad. The main dish, which was some of the most tasty non-barbecued ribs I've ever tasted.
Non-barbecued ribs.
That's intriguing.
Well, I'm honestly interested to know how else you can cook ribs. That's fascinating. Mm-hmm. I think that's awesome.
And this will be.
Here we go. This is dessert, isn't it?
Well, you're going to be very disappointed when you hear what he said about dessert.
Oh.
See what that says.
Something chocolate.
Chris is a beer fan, so they were welcomed with a Lucifer. St. Bernardus Wit.
I don't even know what to say to that.
Glasentorn Saison der Mer. I got through that one, okay. Poppering's Hummel Ale, West Malle Double, and Castile Rouge. It was $57 for the whole thing, and he said it was well worth it.
Wow, that's not a bad deal.
And they've got they got plans to do these every quarter, so we have the dates for the next one. So we might actually do one of these. Actually hook up with listener Chris for that one. He also said that the next one may feature beers from Apiece.
Oh, the pizza place.
Right, and you've never been there.
I have not.
One of my former employers has an annual reunion party every year at Apiece. And because one of the guys who is one of the party organizers is actually a partner in the restaurant/bar. And it's really, really good. And one day we'll head over there.
We should.
We just had our reunion party. Was it in January? It was in December. It was before Christmas, I think.
Yeah. So, early December.
So that's another place to come on there. So thank you, Chris, for that review. And don't forget, if you want to send us a review, please do so. We'll give our contact information at the end of the show, although most of you know what it is already. But that's okay. Stick around. There's more to it. I also wanted to mention...
Have we hit 1747 or whatever yet?
Oh, we've blown past it.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so...
Sorry.
This would be really cool. So whatever we said at 1747, play it backwards.
You can't play stuff backwards on your iPod.
Sure you can.
On your iPod?
Well, not on your iPod, but you can do it on your computer.
Sure. Play the whole thing backwards, in fact. See what you come up with.
Okay. In the last episode, I also threw something out there to see if anyone could guess what this trivia thing was. And we got a bunch of emails on this, but mm-hmm. no one has gotten it right.
Do you want to refresh
the quote, us? The quote was, "Show today is crowded, so we must move quick." Now, I had a bunch of people who emailed us who said it sounded like it was from the Rocky and Bullwinkle TV show or the mm-hmm. Rocky and Bullwinkle movie with Robert De Niro. I don't know if you ever saw that.
No.
It was actually pretty good. I saw it with the kids when it came out. Somebody thought it might have been from Ferris Bueller. Somebody thought it was from... Somebody said Austin Powers.
These are all very reasonable guesses.
They're all very reasonable guesses, but they are all incorrect. So rather than drag this thing out needlessly.
Because who could stand another Fortnite? So please, fill us in.
Okay, so I'll fill you in. Well, here, I will play it for you now in its original context.
3CP1 on your dial, Russian television.
People, this is Today is Moscow. I am Valery Kometsky.
And I am Ivan Mihailov. Show today is crowded, so we must move quick.
First, we say welcome to new viewers in Melonville and Tri-City area.
Okay, those were the voices of Rick Moranis and Dave Thomas, and that was from SCTV.
Naturally, the Russian TV.
Yeah, it's called the 3CP1 episode.
Oh,
where
yeah.
the Russian satellite came up and jammed the SCTV satellite, so their entire programming day was interspersed with Soviet programming.
It's pretty funny Cold War humor. Late Cold War humor.
Exactly. And then a few years later, it was all over. for both SCTV and the Soviet Union. Unfortunately, but no cheap date swag or apple butter or anything like that. But coming up in the very near future, and this is the teaser, we're not giving any more information about this right now. We have a contest coming up in which fabulous prizes, real fabulous prizes, will
like
be...
Like not just junk with our logo.
Exactly. Real fabulous prizes will be given away. So by all means, stick around for that because we think you'll...
Are employees of Cheap Date Enterprises eligible?
No, you're not going to have an inside track on this. I'm sorry. More details to follow on that soon. We covered Lamplighter. We covered Durty Nellie's. We covered Carefree $5, $375 Lightning Googles.
Mm-hmm.
Is there anything else we need to cover?
I don't think so.
Then let's let these people go, shall we?
We shall.
If people want to get a hold of us, Lisa, how should they do that?
I suggest email. Our email address, as they likely know, is cheapdateshow@gmail.com.
Or you can leave us a voicemail at 206-203-3283. And I guess that's about it.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll talk to you guys in a fortnight. We hope you had a wonderful Valentine's Day.
Aww.
Aww.
We had a wonderful Valentine's Day.
We sure did. Have a great fortnight, everybody. We will talk to you soon.
Good night.
This podcast is a production of Cheap Date Media at cheapdatemedia.com.